Dear viewers, now I am going to present a paper entitled Lower Paleolithic Culture, Sohanian and Madrasian. Now come to the introductory part. The Lower Paleolithic culture in India is considered to have two distinct traditions. That is, number A, the Sohanian, also known as Sohanian, and represented by pebble tools or chopper chopping tool tradition. And number B, the Acheulean, also referred as Madrasian, represented by biface or hand axe cleaver tradition. The Sohanian artifacts are found in the north of Indo-Gangetic plain, whereas the Madrasian or Acheulean artifacts are found mostly in peninsular India. It was Ice Ditera and T.T. Patterson and V.D. Krishnaswamy who suggest the existence of two independent cultures within the Lower Paleolithic culture of India. Now come to the Sohanian culture. In the early 1930s, Ice Ditera and T.T. Patterson interpreted and labeled some of the lithic assemblages found in the Shivalik region as Sohan or Sohanian, and subsequently researchers like Ice L. Mobius considered the Sohanian culture as a part of the chopper chopping tool traditions of Southeast Asia. The name Sohanian is derived from the Sohan River and the terrace gravel and associated lois deposits of the Indo-Sohan in the Potwar region of Pakistan. Sohanian artifacts are conventionally differ from the Acheulean artifacts. The Sohanian artifacts primarily consist of amorphous unifacial tools on cores and rarer bifacial pieces, whereas the Madrasian or Acheulean artifacts consist of biface such as hand axes, cleavers and picks on cores, and flax and unifacial tools types of on cores and reader's flax. The Sohanian artifacts are manufactured on quartzite pebbles, cobbles and occasionally on boulders, and the assemblages are generally comprised varieties of choppers, discoids, scrapers, cores, and numerous flax types, all occurring in varying typotechnological frequencies at individual sites. Most of the sites bearing Sohanian artifacts are surface sites, so dating is limited to relative dating. The Sohanian has been further classified into early and late Sohanian. Early Sohanian is a Mode 1 technology, although it may be late Pleistocene, and late Sohanian is Mode 3 technology. The late Sohanian is rich in pebble tools and dated to between 50 to 20,000 years. The early Sohanian is technologically related to the Lower Paleolithic, but without hand axes or cleavers. The site of Toka, studied by Part R. Chauhan, probably represents late Lower to early Middle Paleolithic technology. Stephen Lysit has also arrived on a similar conclusion on the prominent presence of the Levallois or a Mode 3 element through a comparative assessment of morphometric variables on some original cores of Sohanian tradition collected by Ditera and Patterson, and further infers that at least some sites within the Sohan Valley contain a clear Mode 3 Levallois core component, which is consistent with the hypothesis that the Sohanian techno-complex is either late Acheulean or post-Acheulean in terms of technology. However, Gaillard showed that neither the Sohanian nor any other chopper chopping tool industries contemporary to the Acheulean are found in the sub-Himalayan region of the Indian subcontinent. The Sohanian, long considered as a component of the Lower Paleolithic Mode 1, comes from later contexts than the Acheulean and dates to the late Pleistocene. From the above discussion, we can see how the identity of the Sohanian has been changing over time. On the technological ground, Sohanian artifacts have Middle Paleolithic or Mode 3 elements, and chronologically, it occurs in a later context than the Lower Paleolithic Acheulean or Madrasian. Now come to the Madrasian or Acheulean culture. India is one of the areas of largest concentration of Madrasian or Acheulean sites. This has been revealed by multiple surveys and excavation over the last half century. British geologist Robert Bruce Putte, the father of the Indian prehistory, first discovered a handaxe from Pallavaram near Madras, now it is known as Chennai, on 30th of May 1863. There are several best-studied areas of Madrasian or Acheulean occurrences, such as the Third Desert, the Son and Bilan Valley, the Bhimbetka area of Raijin district of Madhya Pradesh near the Narmada Valley, Maharashtra and southern India. The salient features of the Madrasian or Acheulean culture of India, as discussed by R.S. Papu in his book Acheulean Culture in Peninsular India and Ecological Perspective, are classified into five groups. They are listed in the following. Number 1. Distribution and habitat pattern. Long-term research in different parts of the country shows that Acheulean artifacts are found to have distributed all over the country except certain pockets such as the Indo-Gangetic Plains. Probably due to the non-availability of rocks necessary for preparing stone artifacts, or if any Acheulean or Madrasian sites existed there in the past, they got buried subsequently under the thick alluvium, northeast India and along the west coast and the western ghats due to rough terrain, heavy rainfall and thick vegetation. The sites occur in varied geographical landscape, such as arid to semi-arid regions of western Rajasthan, forested and hilly regions of Vindhyan region and Chotanagpur plateau, coastal regions of Orissa, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu, river terraces of Shivalik regions and plateau regions of the Deccan upland, rock exposures in central India and Karnataka, and in rock shelters and caves, which all together indicate the ecological adaptations to the Madrasian or Acheulean hominids. R.S. Papu has classified the Acheulean sites into five groups: alluvial, coastal, slough, surface of or falling in the open air sites and rock shelters and cave sites. The Acheulean population lived mostly close to the river banks, sea and lake shores, and in the foothill areas for easy access and exploitation of perennial water, plant and animal foods, and raw materials for making stone tools, etc. Some of the best studied and well-known excavated open-air sites are Sirki Nevasa in Maharashtra, explored and excavated by Gurdon Cornibus, Lalitpur in Uttar Pradesh, it was explored and excavated by R. Singh. Next, Hunsgi and Baisbal Valley in Karnataka. It was explored and excavated by K. Padaya. Next is Paishara in Bihar. It is done by P.C. Pant and Bidula Jaiswal. Next is Rajan district in Madhya Pradesh. It is done by J. Jacob. Anagwari in Karnataka. It is explored and excavated and studied by R.S. Papu and Sushma G. Dio. Next is Morgaon in Maharashtra. It is worked by Shaila Mishra. Next is Bori in Maharashtra. It is done by B.S. Kale and R. Porishetta. Next is Attirampakkam site in Tamil Nadu. It is worked by Shanti Papu. Next is Bilan Valley in Uttar Pradesh. It is explored and excavated by G.R. Sharma. Next is Son Valley in Madhya Pradesh. It is also the work of G.R. Sharma and J.D. Clark. Next is Didwana in Rajasthan. This site is explored and excavated by P.N. Mishra, S.N. Rajaguru and Claire Gaillard. The rock shelters and cave sites include Adangar in Madhya Pradesh. It is the work of R.B. Joshi. And Bhimbetka in Madhya Pradesh is also the work of B.N. Mishra. Not much is known about the habitation structures or dwellings of the Acheulean period except the evidence of the construction of a wall of boulders for partitioning the interior space in one of the rock shelters of Bhimbetka. An oval-shaped living floor surrounded by granite boulders on all sides deliberately placed by men for constructing hut-like structure at Hunsgi. Stone alignments in habitation floors, post hole at Paishara, etc. Now come to the next point, number 2, Madrasian or Acheulean stone tool typology and technology. The lower Paleolithic artifacts consist of hand axes, cleavers, both having a variety of shapes and forms, choppers, scrapers, discoids, points, borers, polyhedrons, spheroids, etc. The hand axe is one of the standardized tool types, which is teardrop in shape and pointed at the tip with sharp cutting edges on the lateral sides, whereas the cleaver is characterized by broad cutting edge, usually at right angles to the long axis. The main techniques used in making these tools are block on block, stone hammer and soap hammer or cylinder hammer. The raw materials used for fashioning the Acheulean or Madrasian artifacts are quartzite, basalt, dolerite, granites, sirti limestones, etc., depending on the availability. Now come to the third point, geological, paleontological and paleoanthropological background. The quaternary formations associated with Madrasian or Acheulean industries include glacial, fluvio-glacial, fluvial, lacustrine, fluvio-lacustrine, Aeolian, littoral and colluvial deposits, which contain Paleolithic tool assemblages and also mammalian fossil remains. The geoarchaeological and paleoenvironmental studies show that there were climatic fluctuations, sea level changes, and tectonic movements in the Indian subcontinent during the Quaternary period in terms of the past environment, particularly paleoclimate. Localities bearing fossilized bones of mammalian species have been discovered in the Karawas of Kashmir. The Shivalik formation in the sub-Himalayan region in Punjab and Himachal Pradesh, the alluvial deposits of Narmada and Mahanadi in Madhya Pradesh, Bilan Valley in Uttar Pradesh, Parabhra, Godavari, Krishna, Ghat, Manjra valleys in Maharashtra and Hunsgi, Tungabhadra and Ghataprabha valley in Karnataka. The Pownal remains associated with the Acheulean or Madrasian artifacts are the Elipus nomadicus, Stegodon Ganesa, Stegodon insignis, Bos nomadicus, Icus nomadicus, Bubalus Peliindicus, Cervus Dubhauxeli, Rhinoceros unicornis, Hippopotamus Peliindicus, Leptobos Fraseri, Ursus nomadicus, Sioux species, Trionic species, and Imi species, etc. The partial cranium of advanced Homo erectus or archaic Homo sapiens, discovered by Arun Sonakia in 1982 and a hominid clavicle in 1997 by A.R. Sankian in the basal gravel of the Narmada alluvium at Hathonora near Hoshangabad in Madhya Pradesh are so far the hominid fossil discoveries in India. Now let's turn to the fourth point, subsistence and settlement pattern. Although there is no direct evidence for reconstructing the subsistence practices of the lower Paleolithic people due to poor preservation of animal and plant remains at excavated primary sites, hunting of animals and gathering of wild plant foods can be considered as a subsistence strategies of the early hominids. The discoveries of a large number of contemporary animal fossils near the Acheulean or Madrasian sites indicate that probably some of these animals were hunted by them besides fishing activities in the nearby perennial streams. Tools like hand axes, cleavers, and scrapers were probably utilized for different activities. Ethno-archaeological study conducted in the Hanski Valley by K. Padaya, Bhimbetka area by B. N. Mishra and Maltinagar, and among the tribal communities like Gons, the Sansus, and the Yerukulas by M. L. K. Murthy, have shown that wild plant foods like fruits, berries, tubers, roots, nuts, seeds, greens, etc. were possibly exploited by the early men. Site catchment analysis, particularly land use pattern, concerning the exploitation of plant, animal, and mineral resources by human groups in a particular territory conducted at a number of Madrasian or Acheulean sites such as Sirki Nevasa, Anakwari, Khyat, and Hanski have furnished the evidences for the range of movement of the Acheulean hunter-gatherers for resource exploitation within a radius of 10 km. Study of the settlement pattern considering the location, distribution, and densities of sites in terms of ecology indicate annual activity cycle of the Madrasian or Acheulean groups and nature of their seasonal settlement system. K. Padaya in 1982 suggests that the Madrasian or Acheulean groups in the Hanski Valley aggregated during the dry season at spring fed water resource and disperse during the wet season. The wet season dispersal with attendant reliance on plant foods and small fauna, and a dry season aggregation characterized by large game hunting were the governing principles of the Hanski Valley settlement system. There are several examples of studies on site formation process which provide a basis for interpreting the duration of human occupation, the continuity or intermittence of occupation, intensity of occupation, rate of deposit formation, post-depositional alterations, and the effects of erosion on the preservation of cultural remains such as by K. Padaya, M. D. Petraglia, Richa Jindal in the Hanski Valley, and Santi Papu in the Quarter Layer Basin, etc. Now let's come to the fifth point, that is origin, chronology, and divisions. To understand the origin and chronology of the Madrasian or Acheulean culture, both relative dating based on the paleontological and geomorphological evidence, and as well as absolute dating with methods like thorium, uranium, potassium, argon, and thermoluminescence have been applied. There are number of Madrasian or Acheulean sites which are dated to the beginning of the Middle Pleistocene, such as Bori in western Maharashtra by Shaila Mishra, Jalalpur and Dina in the Shivalik sediments in Pakistan by Randall and Denel. In 1992, Shaila Mishra brought out the implications of the thorium uranium dates for the Acheulean or Madrasian sites of the Indian subcontinent, and shows that all the sites dated are beyond 350,000 years before present, which is the limit of thorium uranium method. However, the site of Bori with an early Acheulean assemblage has been dated by argon to argon method to 0.67 plus minus 0.03 million years before present. The Acheulean sites of Nevasa, Bori, and Morgaon are dated with paleomagnetism, which suggests a pre-Bronze is less than 0.78 million years before present. It was done by Shaila Mishra in 2006 and 2007. K. Padaya has studied the Hanski and Baiswal Valley of southern India and carried out detailed excavations at the site of Ishampur dated to 1.2 million years by electrospin resonance dating method. Another site, Atirampakkam, located in Quarter Layer River Basin, South India, studied by Santi Papu, has been recently dated to 1.51 plus minus 0.07 million years by using a relatively new technique of cosmic ray exposure dating, in which the time elapsed since the burial of quartzite artifacts is estimated. Interestingly, the new date obtained at the site of Atirampakkam and Ishampur has pushed back the antiquity of Madrasian or Acheulean culture in India to the early Pleistocene age, which compares fairly well with the chronology of the Acheulean in other parts of the old world. In peninsular India, at most of the lower Paleolithic sites, Acheulean artifacts occur in a mixed state. There is as yet no sound stratigraphic evidence to divide the Acheulean or Madrasian into various phases, as have been recognized in Europe and Africa. B. and Mishra in 1978, after comparing the Acheulean assemblages from the Bhimbetka to other excavated Acheulean sites in India, suggests a two-fold division of the Madrasian or Acheulean into early and late Acheulean. The former is characterized by inferior workmanship, as revealed by deep and irregular fractures, thick bodies, and asymmetrical forms. The late Acheulean, on the other hand, includes finer types with smoother surfaces resulting from controlled flaking and symmetrical forms. According to B. N. Mishra, the early Acheulean assemblages are generally court, characterized by such court tools as hand axes, choppers, polyhedrons, and spheroids. A low number of cleavers and flat tools. The predominant use of the stone hammer technique and the absence of the Levallois technique, unquote. Whereas, in contrast, the late Acheulean assemblages are represented, quote, by the low proportion of bifaces, the high ratio of cleavers to hand axes, the very high ratio of flat tools like scrapers, the extensive use of soap hammer technique, and the knowledge of the Levallois and discoid core techniques, unquote. It is also to be remembered that unless these two recognized groups occur in a stratigraphic succession, they do not imply any evolutionary stages. The representative examples of the early Acheulean tradition are Singhi Talab, Ditwana in Rajasthan, Khyat Anakwari and Hanski in Karnataka, Sirki Nabhasa in Maharashtra, Lalitpur in Uttar Pradesh, and Mayurbhans in Orisha. Whereas important examples of the late Acheulean tradition are Gangapur in Maharashtra, Ralakallabha Basin in Andhra Pradesh, Tirumpakkam and Badamadurai in Tamil Nadu, Bhimbetka and Raijan Complex in Madhya Pradesh, and Paleru and Gunjana Valleys in Andhra Pradesh. Now let's come to the concluding part. The Lower Paleolithic culture of India has two distinct cultural traditions. They are the Sohanian and the Madrasian. The Sohanian is also known as chopper chopping tool tradition. The Sohanian artifacts are found in the north of the Indo-Gangetic plain, whereas the Madrasian artifacts are found mostly in peninsular India. Recent discoveries show that both Sohanian and Madrasian sites occur in the Himalayan tract in the Punjab, Himachal Pradesh, and UP and Shivalik frontal range. Sohanian artifacts are conventionally differ from the Madrasian artifacts. The Sohanian artifacts primarily consist of unifacial tools on coarse and rarer bifacial pieces, whereas the Madrasian artifacts consist of biface such as hand axes, cleavers, and picks on coarse and flax, and unifacial tool types on coarse and detached flax. Thank you.